where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. God has hidden unlimited treasures in His Word. Every time we open it, we can discover a new treasure or admire an old one. What will we find today? Let's dig in. Here's Carla Early with Treasure Hunt in the Word.
Today's verses are found in 2 Timothy 2, 1 and 2. You then, my child, be strengthened by the grace that is in Christ Jesus, and what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to faithful men who will be able to teach others also. Do you have a Timothy in your life? Paul was Timothy's mentor. He chose Timothy to travel with he and Silas on their second missionary journey. Eventually, he left Timothy in Ephesus to pastor the church there. But Paul still mentored Timothy with his letters. The first letter had a very personal tone to it, and Paul advised Timothy how to handle false teachers and other problematic areas of church life. He told Timothy not to let anyone look down on him because he was young, but to be a good example to all believers. When Paul wrote 2 Timothy, he knew his time was near. He was imprisoned and had very little time left. This letter is even more personal. Since Paul was single and didn't have any children, and Timothy's father probably died before he met Paul, their relationship was much like a father and a son. God had entrusted Paul with the work of spreading the gospel. In this letter, Paul transfers this mantle to Timothy, his son in the faith. Others had turned away from him, but Paul was confident Timothy would carry on his work. Though he was hoping Timothy would be able to come see him, he knew these may be the very last words to his young friend. He urged Timothy to be strong, not fearful and timid, to stand firm in the grace that Jesus supplies, not to let anything get him down, because God's grace is sufficient for anything. Paul had poured his life into Timothy. He discipled Timothy and had given him various jobs before the pastorate in Ephesus. In these verses, Paul tells Timothy that he needs to find other men to disciple as Paul had discipled him. Then those men were to disciple others. That chain of discipling should continue unbroken through the generations all the way to today, when we should find others to entrust this word to and teach them, and entrust them to teach others also. I love genealogy, and I could spend hours searching on the internet for long-dead relatives. But to think that I might be in the spiritual genealogy of Paul and Timothy is pretty exciting to me. Who knows, you might be too. The thing is, we don't want the genealogy to stop in our generation. We want to make sure it continues. We need to be a Paul to a Timothy, a younger person in the faith, discipling them, pouring our lives into them, teaching them what we've learned. Do you have a Timothy? Or a few of them, maybe? Have you ever been discipled by someone? Who is your Paul? If you don't have either a Paul or a Timothy, God would be happy to provide one for you. Just ask Him. You can contact me at treasurehuntintheword@gmail.com. I'm Carla Early. Thanks for listening. And remember, where your treasure is, there will your heart be also.